substance abuse. There's just the pretty much the approach with adolescents is parallel to the adult approach. There's still, though, and that's pretty much what's here, is just right out of the DSM 4 TR. But as far as what is abuse versus moving on to the actual dependence. And dependence is certainly notable for usually having tolerance or withdrawal, and among some other things here. But again, adolescents are much much less into a definite pattern compared to adults. So even this is something to be aware of when you're working with kids that are coming in with substance abuse problems, that they're not little adults. Now, moving on to what's going on in the brain and some brain chemistry issues. That early trauma, certainly poor attachment, chaos in the family, parental substance abuse, parental mental health problems, and physical illness. All those things have, if we're not careful, a pretty traumatic effect on kids, particularly the first 3 years, and that it more and more we're finding that that does affect the brain development and affects everything from memory to just being able to self-regulate impulsive kinds of behaviors. And also you'll see kids a lot of times that come in that are causing just a lot of problems at school or at nursery school, and being just little bullies, and can be a real tear, but they themselves experience disturbed sleep when they're at home at night. They frequently experience the nightmares, night terrors, and this kind of disturbance. And and these kids then respond to things that are more nonverbal, as far as kids like this respond very well to sensory work, to play therapy work, and that's something that you'll see in the references there with the handout, that there's a number of resources there having to do with play therapy and sensory work, because these kids, just that tactile work with the sand is very healing. In a school setting, kids frequently, after doing sand tray work, come back to the classroom and teachers report